How y'all doing? It's been a while. All right,
we'll start with Rob again.
Olivier, what was the biggest difference for you tonight, bouncing back? You were so efficient, especially on the offensive end.
As a team, I think our mentality was the biggest difference. We kind of strained out and buckled down and just came in with the mentality that we play most of our games with. I think we let that go a little bit last game, and I think we locked in, took the loss the right way, and came in with the right mindset.
What do you see from
Tobe tonight? Man, Tobe is incredible. You know, he's going to come in and he's going to get him some rebounds. He's going to find a way to get on the glass and affect the game with his physicality, and he's going to keep growing in that area. And then, you know, his post game is something he's still figuring out. But as you guys can see, he's strong inside, and, you know, he has a lot of potential.
How did the mentality stuff kind of go wrong against Colorado, and what did the past few days look like in terms of you guys getting that corrected and coming back looking like this?
I think it's easy when you know you have a good team to forget how hard it is. You can't just walk out there and win, even if you're good, especially with the type of teams that we play. You know, our schedule is always tough, so we got to just keep that hard-nosed mentality that we got to go out there and play our game and focus on being the best versions of us and never really worry about who we're playing or are they good or are they not. We just, as long as we're taking care of ourselves and making sure we're coming in the right way, we'll be good.
What did that look like the past few days in terms of getting back to that place?
Honestly, just coming back and practicing hard and doing what we do, you know. For us, it's never really about any kind of magical fix. We know who we are as individuals, and we know who we can be as a team. So, you know, whenever something like that goes down, you know, we talk to each other and we come back and we just keep going harder at practice, going at each other, you know, letting each other know, holding each other accountable. You know, coaches holding us accountable, that's always a great part, big part of it. You know, Coach Barnes going to hold us accountable, and all the assistant coaches will hold us accountable. And as the older team, you know, we're getting better every day, and we've been getting better since I got here at holding each other accountable.
Rick held Zakai accountable on Sunday. Is it any surprise to see him kind of bounce back, respond the way Zakai did?
Zakai's a tough kid. You know, he'll always bounce back. He'll always figure it out. And, you know, you guys know Coach. He will hold people accountable. And there's nothing he'll say to the media that he won't say to you to your face. So it's nothing new. We knew what Coach was going to say. We knew he already said it to us. So it's nothing. We don't really worry about what's going on in the media. We are here. Well, we hear from each other first, and then you guys hear about it later. So we know.
You already touched on it a little bit and coached it as well, but getting back to the identity of this team tonight compared to Colorado, what would you say that identity is? Like, if you had to describe who this Vols team is, who are you guys?
For us, our identity, you know, every year it can change a little bit because of, you know, the teams that we have, but it's always based on being a tough, hard-nosed team, you know, getting on the defensive end. You know, every year that I've been here, we've become a faster-paced team, and that's become a part of our identity now, just, you know, playing with speed, almost a run-and-gun type of mentality, trying to figure out how to play better inside out. But, yeah, being tough is always at the core of our team, and that's how we build our identity, through toughness.
What do you think about the pace tonight, and do you think you guys played a little bit more controlled tonight than against Colorado?
Yeah, I think our guards had a lot more confidence. They had, you know, their mindset, knowing what they wanted to do, knowing where they wanted to get the ball. And I think that that always helps us a lot when we have clear objectives. And, you know, I think we can play fast. I think we played fast tonight, and I think we're going to keep becoming a faster-paced team as the year goes on. As we get used to each other, used to the things that we do, that everybody does. We have new players on the team, you know. I said this earlier, I myself am technically right now kind of a new player on the team. I missed a lot of last year. The team that we were when the year finished, I wasn't a part of that. Now coming back in, I'm figuring out my role, and everybody else is trying to figure out my role as well. So I think our speed is something that's going to keep picking up until we find something that works for us.
Olivier, you talked about being able to sort of accept criticism when you play for Rick Barnes. Is that something that, if a guy doesn't know how to do that, it's going to be tough for him here? It just seems like the guys who hang around for a few years, you just kind of have to have that to play here.
Absolutely. I mean, you guys know Coach. You guys know how he is. You've been around this a long time, probably some of y'all longer than me. He's going to tell everybody what's up. He's going to let you know when you're not doing good and he's going to let you know what he wants from you, what he needs from you, and he's going to be critical. But, you know, he has everybody's best interest at heart, and the things that he's telling you are the hard truths that you need to hear. And it's not for everybody, but as a team, we do our best to help each other out. And the people who are here belong here, and the people who are here, we want them here. And regardless of people who left or stayed, you know, everybody who's come through here has learned something from this place, and that's a great part about this place.
Tell me about Jahmai Mashack, just the way that he's improved this offseason. Pretend he's not behind that curtain right now, if you could.
Nah, Jahmai, man. Jahmai get better every day. Jahmai is now become my favorite 45 cutter. So from now on, whenever I catch the ball on the block, I am expecting him to cut. I think Jahmai is incredible. I think he's figured it out from, in a sense of, he has to keep getting better every day. He has to be willing to learn every day. He has to, you know, take criticism. Jahmai has always been good at, you know, hearing those hard truths. And he's just a hard-nosed guy. You know, he fits us, our standard perfectly. You know, he plays defense hard, and he wants to score. He wants to guard. He wants to win. I've not been around too many guys like that. Somebody I'll compare Jahmai to is Victor Bailey Jr. last year. You guys know how tough he was and how he got his and how, you know, he worked hard, and that's how I see Jahmai, and I think Jahmai is going to keep getting better here, and I think he's going to end up being a great Tennessee Vol. He already is. Thank you for that question.